the butterflies gone, the fat-filled fulufute insects, the inswa, which are our edible insects, or the vinkubala, our mopani worms, where have they gone? There was a time when we were children, would sing a song to celebrate the rainy season, and it goes like this. Imfula isa isa, twangalena mainsa, which actually is a Bemba folklore song sung by children and adults alike to celebrate the rainy season, to celebrate the critters, to celebrate the mushrooms and the wild fruits that sprout with the rainy season. This was a time when we would gather as children at sunset. When we know it's about to rain or that it has rained in the afternoon, would gather huge dishes of water and place them next to the makeshift torches. This would trap the inswa, because the inswa is very rich in protein, and it's a delicacy in many Zambian homes. Who among us sang these songs or celebrated the rainy season? Is it those born in the 70s? Or maybe those who were born in the 80s? Maybe those born in the 90s or the millennials? What about Gen Z, the Generation Z? Do they have their own stories to tell about the rainy season and all the beauty that it brings? Who should we ask about climate change? Is it the Gen Z or it's the old people? Because they have lived through 30-year cycles, which the scientists have used to measure climate change. Or should we ask those born in the 90s, or indeed those born in the 80s? Each of these have their story. Among the elders, should we ask those rich with indigenous knowledge systems, the rural elders? Or should we ask the urbanite elders? Because each of these have their story. For the rural elders, they live in close proximity with the forest. They observe the rise and fall of the water levels in the wells, in the lakes and the rivers too. They know exactly when to plant the crop in the field and when not to plant in the field. They know how to plant or not to plant at all. They know this through indigenous knowledge because they monitor the croaking of the frog or the sound of the cicada at sunset. They monitor as well the mystical rainbow around the moon, which oftentimes is an indicator, an early warning system of the rainy season which is to come. On the other hand, should we ask the urbanite elders, who in most cases have lost the connection with nature? They have a nostalgic memory of maybe the time when they grew up in the village, when they were instructed by their elders how to monitor the environment proximate to them. They were told in their childhood what to do and what not to do according to the phases of the moon and according to the rising and setting of the sun. If we ask them what climate change means to them, will they be able to tell us their story? Or will they keep quiet and learn from science and technology? Only when we take time to listen to all your stories from the urbanites and from the rural community, from the young and the old, will we be able to functionally come up with nature-based solutions? Other people call it climate-resilient solutions. Others still call it sustainable agriculture or climate-resilient infrastructure. All these put together would then resonate what we have learned, what we need to unlearn, and what we need to relearn for us to collectively come up with workable climate solutions. When you sit in solitude and introspect and ask yourself, what does climate change mean to me? Will we be like that man who stood in a fresh spring of water but died of thirst? Will we? Or will we be able to live out climate change in the best way that we know how? In the townships, what does climate change mean to you? In the gated elite estates, how do we live through climate change? In the communities, in the forest communities, in the rural communities, in the countryside, what does climate change mean to the women? Is it the change of soil, the loss of their herbs, the finishing of their water? Or is it that the air has changed? For the men, so what that there's climate change? What does it mean to you? For the Gen Z and the millennials, is climate change an app, or is it the new lingo that we don't understand but surely you communicate through? I would like to ask you to take a silent moment and think about Indigenous knowledge systems. If it worked for them, what can we learn for it to work now? If we have a scientific technological mindset, is the technology being crafted every other day workable as a solution to mitigating climate change? It takes you and it takes me, it takes all of us to resonate to what we think climate change means to us. Thank you very much.